two advisors to Oppenheimer, namely Bacher, who had been my colleague at Cornell and who was now at the radiation lab, and Rabi, who was associate director of the radiation lab, were advising Oppenheimer and told him, well, it's impossible to run the lab with 20 independent groups all funneling into your brain. You have a marvelous brain, but you can't direct all of this yourself. You have to have a structure as the radiation lab had, namely the lab was first divided into divisions, each division having maybe 5 to 10 groups, and each group having maybe 5 to 10 scientists in it. And they then recommended to Oppenheimer to appoint me as the leader of the theoretical division. That, at the beginning, had about, 20 or 30 members. At the end, it was about 100. A very small division in the big lab. But we had a very interesting time because everything started with theory. I had very able group leaders. One of them was Serber, who had been instrumental at Berkeley. Another was Teller, and still another was Weisskopf, a good friend of mine from Rochester. And then we had several more.